During this lesson, we were practicing how to solve inequalities. The first thing that they had to do was create an inequality, and they had to see the connection between solving a two-step equation and an inequality were basically the same thing. I decided to place my students in cooperative groups where my kids know them more as POC groups, which basically just stands for point of confusion groups. One of the first things that I like to do before working in points of confusion, I give them a problem. It could be something as simple like a two-step or three-step inequality like it's presented here, but sometimes I give them like a performance task. They can work on a performance task, they can work on a real-world problem, or they can work on a project. As I'm walking around, I'm noticing who's struggling with that problem, and then that's when I start kind of addressing what students should probably go first. So we're gonna go ahead and do your point of confusion on number three. When you get this assignment, your worksheet, you're gonna put Quizette, day three, number three. And I'll go ahead and show you guys in a minute. Okay, as soon as you get it, if you understood my instructions, go ahead and follow through. Please make sure you put Quizette. Basically, they just write down the question that they solved, and in the middle section, they're working the problem step by step mathematically, and on the right hand side they're completing it with word phrases. What did you do in step one? If for whatever reason they don't do number step, let's say step two, that's where they address their point of confusion. They acknowledge what they're able to do. I know how to do step one, but where I'm having my point of confusion is completing step two. So when I tell them, okay, get into your groups, they set up their groups, and the first person that's gonna go up, who is gonna be the first presenter, will just basically transfer whatever they wrote on the worksheet, all their work. They'll divide the whiteboard in half. On the, let's say, on the left side, they'll go ahead and write all their steps mathematically, and on the right-hand side, they'll address all their steps in word phrases. And their point of confusion, they'll turn to their facilitators and basically just read.
So first, I subtracted $13 from the budget, because that's the book covers, how much the book covers cost. So then I had to divide 9 into 112 to see how much each book costs. And my point of confusion is, like, how do you do the inequality solution, the inequality? How do you create it?
The role of the facilitators, which for the most part is two or three students sitting at the tables, the role is to facilitate or to give students questions which are intended to help the presenter clarify their point of confusion. They can give them things like a sentence stem where they fill in the blank, such as whatever you do one side of the inequality, you do to the, and the presenter fills in the blank to the other side of the inequality.
Oh yeah, the 13 is the number that we already use on the book cover, so we had to subtract that from the budget.
Okay. Are you sure you subtracted right?
They can give them a guided question, which is, for the most part, they understand that if the facilitator tells you, are you sure that's the correct step? Most likely it's probably incorrect, and you should probably go back and fix that.
Are you sure that's a two-step inequality?
No. Okay, so then I have to
come back. She subtracted wrong.
You subtracted.
You subtracted 13, not 3.
Like 1 minus 1?
I feel point of confusion groups tie in really well with Common Core. One of the S&Ps states that students should be able to construct viable arguments and be able to analyze other students' work, and this is a perfect setting for that. The next piece, which to me is as equally as important as addressing your point of confusion, getting the work done both numerically and in words, the reflection piece. Now, the reflection piece is sometimes the piece that we kind of think, oh, it's not that important, but it definitely is. So now, the reflection piece, I want you guys to make sure that you are addressing your point of confusion. This is what I initially had as a point of confusion, and this is what I learned now. This is what I learned after being in my group. As students are completing the reflection section of the point of confusion worksheet, I'm walking around and I'm kind of getting a glance at the reflection section, and I'm looking at what their point of confusion was and what they learned from their point of confusion. So I'm quickly looking, and that should, what I learned section should clearly state or address their point of confusion. So I'm quickly going around and addressing it, and sometimes I'll go back and I'll ask them, can you go ahead and rethink what you're writing right here, or think it a little bit more through, think about what your point of confusion was, and then make sure that what you learned clearly connects to your point of confusion. So here, exactly what you told me, mm-hmm. I solved the inequality just like I would solve a
two-step equation.
Okay, so I looked for
addition and subtraction.
And then I looked for
multiplication and division.
And then whatever I did to
add it to the other.
Put all that in there. So that's what you learned. A ver.